Beloved brothers and sisters, let us confess our sins to God our Father. I confess to you, most merciful God, that I have sinned against you in my thoughts, words, and deeds. Those that I have done, as well as the good I have failed to do. It is my own sin that condemns me. In your mercy, according to your promise, forgive me my sin. Create a new heart in me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation. For the sake of Jesus Christ, my Lord and my God. Amen.
Amen.
Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the Word, announce the grace of God in you, and in the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord is my strength and my defense. He has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will praise him,
my Father God, and I will exalt him.
You will bring them in and plant them on the mountain of your inheritance.
Let the place, Lord, be made for your glory, the sanctuary, Lord, your hands established. The Lord reigns forever and ever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our Father, through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, you have overcome death and opened the gate of everlasting life to us. Grant that we, who celebrate with joy the day of our Lord's resurrection, may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated. We continue with our reading.
For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ.
Sabbath, at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went over to the tomb. It was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, 'He has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you.'" So the women ran away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them. "Greetings," he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
ក្រោយថ្ងៃឈប់សម្រាកការរៀបចូលនៅអាទិត្យទី1នោះម៉ារីជាអ្នកស្រុកម៉ាដាឡាអាណាម៉ារីមួយទៀតដែលនាំគ្នាទៅមើលធ្នូនោះមានប្រក្រតីជាខ្លាំងបាត់មានទេវតានៃព្រះអម្ចាស់ចុះពីលើមេឃមកមានថ្មចេញពីធ្នូហើយក៏អង្គុយនៅពីលើសន្តានរបស់ទេវតានោះដូចជាផ្នែកបន្ទោហើយសម្លៀកបំពាក់ក៏សស្គុះដូចហេមៈពួកយាវរវត្តក៏ញ័ររន្ធធួតដោយភ័យខ្លាចទេវតា ហើយត្រឡប់ទៅជាមនុស្សស្លាប់តែទេវតានិយាយទៅនឹងស្ត្រីពីរនាក់ថាកុំឲ្យភ័យអីក្បាច់ខ្ញុំដឹងថាអ្នកប្រុសព្រះយេស៊ូវដែលត្រូវឆ្កាតែព្រះអង្គនៅទីនេះទេបើព្រះអង្គមានព្រះជន្មរស់ដល់ទីហើយដោយទីព្រះអង្គមានព្រះបន្ទូលចូលមកមើលបន្លាយដែលព្រះអង្គទុំចុះរួចទៅឆាប់ប្រាប់ដល់ពួកសិស្សព្រះអង្គថាព្រះអង្គមានព្រះជន្មរស់ជាស្លាប់ឡើងវិញហើយនៅក្នុងព្រះអង្គនៅស្រុកកាលីលេនោះអ្នករត់គ្នា
អ្នករត់គ្នានឹងទ្រង់នៅស្រុកនោះណែខ្ញុំបានប្រាប់អ្នករត់គ្នាហើយស្ត្រីនេះអ្នកនោះក៏ហើយទេនោះជាប្រញាប់ទាំងបីហើយមានស្ត្រីកំណត់មកជាខ្លាំងក៏រត់ទៅប្រាប់ពួកសិស្សតែការនាងមកគង់តែទៅនោះព្រះយេស៊ូវទ្រង់មកគង់នឹងនាងនាងមានព្រះបន្ទូលថានាងមានព្រះបន្ទូលជម្រាបសួរអ្នករត់អ្នកទាំងពីរក៏ចូលទៅទៀតឲ្យព្រះបាទថ្វាយបង្គំទ្រង់នោះព្រះយេស៊ូវទ្រង់មានព្រះបន្ទូលទៅនាងថាក៏ប្លែកអីចូលទៅប្រ